a way that we see business done a lot in the mixed martial arts world, to see promotions working together. Why does this make sense to you to do business this way?
まあ2015年にライジングスタートして3年半ですけども、まあ、僕らはフェデレーションをそういうプロモーションではなくフェデレーションという構想を持っていて、とにかくこの産業ミックスマーシャルアーツって産業がこれからさらに伸びていくためには、もうプロモーションの中の順位決定戦ではなくプロモーションを飛び越えて本当に世界一誰が強いんだってその階級の中でそういうことを決めていけるような中、そういうアクションをこのスポーツの中で取る必要がある。だから僕らは、まあ、負けることを恐れずにチャンピオン同士を戦わせるってことを、まあ、昔からの友達でもあって今回はスポットに話して、恐れずにチャレンジしようということになって実現します。
So initially when we started in 2015, the whole idea was to have a federation, to not have fighters compete within one organization, so you turn who's number one within the organization, but to deliver what the fans want to see, who's number one in the world. So that was the initial idea, and for us, we need to challenge and we need to go out there and take some risks and don't fear the risks behind sending a champion over to fight a champion. And that was the idea. So I Sakagura-san brought up the idea to a longtime friend, Mr. Scott Coker, and that's how everything got started.
I gotta ask, were there nerves when it happened? When you're watching your guy go against the other guy, is there a special feeling of concern or nerves?
まあ、ファンもそうだと思うんですね。ファンも多分その団体を背負ったり、あとはナショナリズムで国を背負ったりということもそうだと思うし、プロモーター同士もワクワクするけど、やっぱり勝てば嬉しいし、負ければやっぱり悔しいと思うし、まあ、でもそれがこのスポーツにとってとっても大事なエッセンス、成功するためのエッセンスで、ファンがワクワクしてもらう、それと同時にプロモーターもワクワクするから、それがキーだと思います。
I think we have the same nerves as the fans. A lot of fans would definitely pick a side and obviously cheer for their nation, for their country, fighters for their country. But as a promoter, there's definitely a lot of things that go through your mind when you're fighting, when the fighters are fighting. So I think whatever the fans want is what the promoters should deliver.
Do you think cross-promoting is healthy for the MMA industry? And if so, would you like to see more, not only with Bellator, but with other promotions as well?
お互いにとってそれぞれの国、僕らはまあ日本がメインの国でね、だから今回でも多分ベラトールをこれまで見てなかった日本の多くのファンが、総合格闘技のファン、スポーツのファンがベラトールのその大会を見ることになる、それをダゾーンを通じて見ることになると思いますし、逆にベラトールで今回僕らね、ライジンのファイターでトップのレナとか森口が出ることでライジンということを知ってもらうことになる、これはお互いにとってとってもいいクロスプロモーションになると思います。
Yeah, I do believe that cross promoting is a fantastic thing for the sport. And for both sides. Obviously, a lot of Japanese people will be introduced to Bellator through DAZN because of this fight. And we do believe that a lot of Americans or people watching DAZN will be introduced to Ryzen and Ryzen fighters because of this crossover. So overall, yes, it's definitely beneficial for both parties and it's definitely a healthy thing for this industry.
Have you and Scott spoken about the potential for a Ryzen versus Bellator tournament?
もちろんこれは別に堀口とかレアに限ったことじゃないんで、ね、団体対団体でどんどん選手を積極的にチャンピオン同士がクロスしてお互いトレードしてっていうか交換していきますから、最終的には本当にベラトール対ライの団体の意思というかね、それぞれのプロモーションというかチームの支援をかけたそういう全面対抗戦っていうのができたらいいですね。
Yeah, the idea is, the idea is not to stop here with Reina and Horiguchi. The idea is to continue to interact and incentivize one another. So eventually, if we continue that, it will probably lead to something more like a fighters representing their organization on one side and the other side representing the other. So eventually, it will probably lead there. But right now, it's just a beginning. But eventually, you know, there's something to be looked at.
If Haraguchi wins, he has both belts. Is the plan for him to defend both belts or both organizations?
Yeah, 堀口は忙しくなる.
Yes.
この場で言っておきますけど、堀口.
I believe that Horiguchi is going to get busy. He's going to become busy because he's done already.
Which one would
he have to keep for? Two belts day after tomorrow. Because I guarantee Horiguchi will win.
Yeah. Okay, hypothetically, say Darien wins and then 1-1. You know, fans don't want a trilogy fight. Which organization is going to host a trilogy fight?
Maybe we can take the middle and do something in Hawaii.
で、1ラウンド目ドローして、1ラウンド目ケージとリング組んどいて、どっちかで1ラウンド、2ラウンド目
Maybe we can have both cage and ring set up and we can draw from a hat and see which rules we do for the first round.
Is there any interest in potentially doing a tournament with a mix of Ryzen and Bellator fighters in the future? Is that ever possible?
そうだね。もちろん僕らとしては今年のライト級のグランプリを秋からスタートしようと思います。そこには本当にベラトールの、ベラトールの代表する選手も出てきてほしいと思うし、僕らはサッカーでいうところのチャンピオンズリーグにしたいと思うので、これはまあ本当に世界中の大中小関わるプロモーションを代表する選手たちをピックアップして、格闘技界のチャンピオンズリーグみたいなものをやって、そこで。
Yeah, definitely. The idea for this year is to hold a lightweight Grand Prix this year, starting August. And hopefully, it would be great to have a Bellator fighter in that Grand Prix as well. So ultimately, you know, our goal idea is to put on the Champions Leagues of MMA. So we hope to have many fighters from proudly representing their countries and promotions to participate in the tournament.
One of the fighters who's done a lot of crossover was King Mo, and he just retired from MMA the other day. Do you have any thoughts on his career and kind of what he meant to MMA and his ability to fight between organizations?
もうやらないんだから本当にまあ彼は本当日本でこの MMA のキャリアをスタートしたってこともあって、彼自身がやっぱり日本に対して特別な思いがあったっていうのが一つ大きかったと思います。だからまあ本当にこのキングモーという選手のように日本で戦うことにも抵抗がなく戦う特別な思いを持って戦える選手がベラトルにいたってことは僕らにとってはこの2つのプロモーションが交流する上でね、全体を交流する上ではなっていると思います。
I think the fact that King Mo was a Bellator fighter, which made his professional debut in Japan, and who had a special place in his heart in Japan. A fighter like that being under the Bellator roster definitely helped us with this first getting our, starting the first step towards this movement. So, you know, having a fighter like that, that had a special place in Japan, and who was fighting the Bellator, that was definitely a great way to start off this moment.
Madison Square Garden is universally recognized as one of the biggest and most important sporting venues in the world. How do you and your fighters feel about not only coming to America to showcase your talents, but also to the world's most famous arena?
本当に光栄に思います。僕自身もマディソン・スクエア・ガーデンで自分のところの代表選手を代表して送り出せる、それがマディソン・スクエア・ガーデンであるということだけでも他のありえないよりも何倍も興奮してるし、まあ、本当にここで最初にキックオフ、内陣の選手がアメリカでスタートする 合をすることができるということを嬉しく思うし、光栄に思います。
It's a definite honor for us to be able to kick off Japanese Fighters Flight in the United States, starting off at the Madison Square Garden. It's an absolute honor, and for me myself, being able to send our fighters to a U.S. promotion, to Bellator, for that, starting off at the Madison Square Garden is something that's very exciting for me.
I have a question.
One championship that they opened up offices in America, possible events in America. He's done events with Pride in America. Any chance we see a rising event in America or an office in America? And a TV deal in America.
アメリカで、アメリカが本当にこのスポーツをやっぱりスポーツとしてこのミックスマーシャルアーツっていうものを育て上げた国の、まあ、ナンバーワンだ、ナンバーツーは日本だと思うんですけど、生まれたのがアメリカで育てたのが日本で、その後またアメリカで大きくしてだから、そのもちろんアメリカという国は僕らのにとってもライジンにとっても憧れの国になるし、なくてはならないマーケットだと思って、そこにはでも大切、あの本当にアメリカで僕らが一回だけ思い出作りにやるってことができる、その意味がないので、しっかり戦略と準備をしてパートナーをしっかり見つけて、もっと力をつけてから、あの本格的にアメリカには上陸したい、僕らの一つの目標、の大きな数年先の目標だと思います。
So how I look at MMA is that United States created MMA, Japan made it bigger, and then the United States finalized it and made it into a complete sport. So with that all being said, we do believe that United States is, America is, right, is essential and be ready for us to come into the United States market. But yeah, that's definitely one of the things that we have.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.